Clemson members, hope you guys are doing well. Over the past couple summers, my favorite class to teach has been our cardio tennis class. The reason I love it so much is not because I get to run you guys around in circles, but it's because that we get to focus all of our 60 minutes on our cardio fitness. So in this next video, I'm going to show you 3 at-home cardio tennis drills that you can do without a tennis court, without me telling you what to do. All you need is yourself and a tennis racket. All right, so for the first drill, what we're going to work on is we're going to go through our quick foot ladder. I bet what most of you guys are thinking is, I do not have a quick foot ladder at home, and that is totally okay. If you have something like sidewalk chuck, you can draw in your own quick foot ladder. Mine is a little bit smaller than normal, just so I can fit it in the frame, but you guys can make yours as long as you want. I also have 2 cones on the edges. This is where we're going to work on our shadow swing. So you're going to start whatever side you want to start on. I'm going to start on my backhand because I love my backhand. So what you're going to do is you're going to shadow swing your backhand, go 2 feet through the quick foot ladder facing you guys, and then do your forehand on that side. So it should look something like this. So the reason why we do this is, one, the quick foot ladder works on your quick feet and staying on your toes. And the reason we put cones on the other side for you to shadow swing is so it kind of emphasizes that you're moving out towards the ball, having very fast feet, and once you get there, you're stopping, you're hitting through the ball, and then you're going back to the other side court for another shot. All right, so for the second drill, we're gonna be working on our cone touches. So I have taken away the quick foot ladder, but I have left our cones. So what we're gonna be working on, like I said, is touching the cones, but working on our lateral movements while also staying low. If I were to tell you guys to go out and just start touching the cones when I said go, I feel like a lot of us would go here and then turn all the way around and start to run to the other cone. But when you're turning your body and then turning the other way, you're taking little split seconds away from you getting to that ball faster. So what we're going to be working on is staying, we'll say, facing the net the whole time and not allowing our body to turn and run. So it should look something like this. Stuff like this for fun, that's gonna help you guys get faster on the tennis court.